At para talakayin ang issue na kinahaharap ni Pacman, kasama natin ngayong gabi ang veteran boxing analyst na si Ronnie Nathanielsz. Ronnie, thank you so much for coming here to
My
the
pleasure.
Score.
My
joining
pleasure.
Joining us once again. We know you have a lot to say about this issue, so we'll just let you go right ahead.
Well, firstly, as far as Nike's contract is concerned, they don't have a financial contract. That's lapsed. That's over and done with. Mm. All they do, as Manny pointed out, is supply him with apparel. That's no big deal.
Yeah.
So he's not losing anything financially. But they have tried to make out that he's losing a lot. He is not. He can wear any Filipino apparel. He can wear Axel. He can wear No Fear or whatever it is. Doesn't make a difference. It's what he does in the ring that's important.
So just to be clear, they are not giving him any financial consideration
on a regular basis. No, certainly not.
What about the comments of Bob Arum? What are your thoughts on that?
What is that exact word he used?
Reprehensible.
Reprehensible. Well, I thought that was very unbecoming of Bob Arum for him to do that. Look, he has made a ton of money, more than one ton of money, out of Pacquiao over the last 9 or 10 years. He has never given Pacquiao his just due financially. And that's what Mayweather has been bitching about all of these years. He suffered the same thing. Floyd Mayweather suffered the same thing. Diego Corrales suffered the same thing. Miguel Garcia suffered the same thing. And they all left Arum and did so much better after they left Arum. Look at Mayweather. When he was with Arum, what did he earn? Peanuts. Now, look at the money he earns. Look at the stature of Mayweather. He's managing himself. And that's what he has been telling Pacquiao to do. Get out of Bob Arum, manage your own career. Mm-hmm. You'll do so much better.
So do you think, Mr. Ron, that this could be the trigger that separates Manny Pacquiao from Bob Arum?
Well, it'll be up to Bob Arum because he holds the contract.
Talking about the incident itself, Mr. Ron, I know everybody's entitled to have his own personal opinion. What do you make of it? And if there was a mistake from Pacquiao, what was his mistake?
His mistake was a mistake of indiscretion. Mm-hmm. I mean, considering the environment, considering the situation he is in now, running for political office, he should have been a little more circumspect in saying what he said. But he stands by what he said, and I support him on that, because what he said was very different from what is made out to be that he said. He said he's against same-sex marriages. That is the position of the Catholic Church in this country, and 86% of Filipinos are Catholics. Mm-hmm. So why doesn't anybody attack the Catholic Church for its stand? That's not fair.
But the damage has already been done, Ronnie. Huge uproar from the LGBT community. So if you were in Manny's shoes, what do you think Manny should do next?
Well, he apologized. That's all he could do, unless they want him to hang himself. You know, he apologized. What more can a man do if he in his conscious mind felt he made a mistake? Mm-hmm. He apologized for hurting people, but he never, in fairness to him, he showed the guts to stand by his position, not like most other politicians who are wishy-washy and don't have the courage to stand by their convictions. He did, and I salute him for that.
Nike is one of the biggest global brands. Do you think any other brands will follow suit?
No, actually, the majority of his endorsements come from local. Mm-hmm. PLDT, Smart, East-West Bank, Bench, all of those other companies that are local. And I don't think they're going to abandon them. You've got to understand, basically, naman. May utang na loob ng Pilipino. The Filipinos are very forgiving. So on those two counts, I think he's not going to suffer because alam mo na, yung tao natin, they know that Pacquiao brought so much pride and joy to Filipinos. He helped this country redeem its position internationally at a time when we were almost down and out. He brought us back into recognition internationally, both by his exploits in the ring and his performance outside the ring, because he's a decent, good human being. Now, he stood by the scriptures. How can you take issue with that? I mean, he was standing by God's word as far as he understands it and appreciates it. And He never condemned gays. He only condemned marriage between the same sexes. That's all it is.
Now, of course, Manny will be returning to the ring to face Timothy Bradley. How will this issue affect that fight?
Actually, to be honest with you, that fight is a nothing fight. From day one, when Bob Arum announced that it was Timothy Bradley, the whole world said, what? Uh-huh. Timothy Bradley again? Come on. He whipped him the last time. Yeah. He whipped him the first time, but the judges whipped Pacquiao. They stole the fight from him. So what's there to settle here? It's not a fight that attracted attention mm-hmm. from the media and from the regular fight fans. So even if it doesn't do well, it's not because of this issue. It's because the fight itself is not an exciting fight.
So if you feel, Mr. Ron, that the fight itself is not an exciting fight, and I would assume it would for you, it would not be a fight that you would like Manny to end his career on.
No.
What do you think would be... Would there be a next fight for him? And if ever, who would it be?
I'm telling you, young man, that not long from now, mm-hmm. if Bob Arum stands by his word, he doesn't like what Manny said, and you know, terminates the contract, let him do that. Because he and Mayweather will get together and put on another fight, a rematch, and they'll make maybe 2-3 million pay-per-view hits. That's what Mayweather is waiting for, I'm telling you. That's what Mayweather is waiting for.
So you're saying that you see another fight between Manny Pacquiao and Floyd Mayweather Jr. in the future?
Yes, of course. Once the contract with Arum expires in early 2016, or Arum decides to terminate the contract. If he has the courage to match his deeds with the words, then Manny is home free. And he and Mayweather can get together, and Manny will make a lot of money.
Yeah, because by the way Bob Arum sounds, it seems that he is no longer really 100% behind Manny Pacquiao. Is there anybody telling Manny Pacquiao to try to read between the lines, Mr. Ron?
No, I don't know, because Michael Conz is his advisor. And Michael Conz is a Bob Arum boy. Come on, let's be honest about this. He is Bob Arum's mole in the Pacquiao camp, you know. And so Bob Arum gets all his... Bob Arum and Mike Conz negotiates Pacquiao's contracts, not Pacquiao. So his advisor does. And then the two of them get together, and Pacquiao is getting the short end of the bargain. Because, I mean, he's not getting, like Mayweather said to me, he is not getting what he deserves. Nowhere near. Even in that fight of the century, he didn't collect what he is supposed to collect. That's what Alex Ariza keeps telling me over and over again. Get away from Bob Arum, team up with Mayweather, you got something going.
Wow. What about Manny's fight in the political arena? How will this issue affect that, him running for senator?
I don't think it will, quite honestly. I hope Filipinos are more intelligent than that by not letting an issue like this take away what he has been able to achieve through the years. You got to, you know, people raise the issue of his absences in Congress. Come on. Every congressman who goes there raises his hand for the roll call and then disappears. Okay, that's the story of Congress. I have covered Congress for so many years. Now, Pacquiao has been there on 4 occasions because he wanted to be there on important issues and stayed there. Outside that, he goes to his province, helps the poor, builds houses for the homeless, buys land for them, teaches them to protect the environment. And he does a lot of very, very good things that congressmen should be doing. But many of them, instead of doing that, they take our money and put it in their pockets.
Mr. Ron, you've followed Manny Pacquiao ever since the start of his career. Seeing him at this stage right now, seeing also the boxing landscape, how many good fights do you think are left in the tank for Manny Pacquiao?
Well, I think he has a couple of good fights left in him. Mm-hmm. But Mayweather, a rematch with Mayweather, will be the summit.
Assuming it doesn't happen right away, is there anybody you would like to see him fight before Mayweather?
No, let him go to the elections, although they are now trying to get him disqualified also, saying that this is an unfair advantage. But my God, this is his profession, this is his life. He has been doing this all these years. Nay never complained about it. In fact, for him to train, he got permission from the Speaker of the House to take off and train. So what's the big deal? Like I said earlier today, the Comelec should look at more important things by implementing the rules that are guaranteed under the Constitution and the rules governing elections, not get little into little petty things like trying to disqualify Pacquiao. Get real.
Mr. Ron, anything more you want to add before we leave this issue?
No, I don't want to get you into trouble anymore.
Well, you certainly had a lot to say tonight. Yeah, Thank you so much, Mr. Ron.
To me, tell it like it is.
Yeah.
Tell it like it is. And to hell with what people think or what people say. You know, some people criticized him. Like, for instance, I'd like to make specific mention of one of the guys who belong to this community, who criticized Pacquiao. But look who's talking. He's the same guy who called Jessica Soho a pig. What's a pig? A pig is an animal. Come on. For him to make that kind of statement is not good. And he's the one pontificating, just like Nike. Nike uses kids, pays them poorly. They make the shoes in terrible conditions. Uh-huh. And then they're pontificating that like there's God's gift to humanity. Mm-hmm. Come on, give us a break.
Well, Mr. Ron, we've covered a whole range of topics and truly valuable insight from you, Mr. Ron.
Thank you for
your valuable insight.
My pleasure.
Thank you
for guesting on the score. I love being here.
Thank you so much.
We can settle the score.